Hey guys.
Hello.
How are you in there?
We're doing well.
All right, as Mike just shared with us, we've got Crystal Gravy in Studio 105 here at WNUR 89.3 FM, Evanston, Chicago, on this rainy September 13th, 2008 day. And we've got John on trumpet, Bill on bass, Logan on drums, Drew on guitar, Charly on percussion, Matt on tenor sax, and Brent on bari sax. And Logan, how would you describe you guys?
We are an instrumental funk septet. We play a lot of original music. We throw in some covers here and there, covers from 60s, 70s, and for the past 6 years, too. And but mostly we play original music. We're going to play all original music tonight, except for one Nigerian tune. And that's pretty much what we do. We try to stay creative with it. And we try to make people sweat and dance and drink and have a good party every time we play out live.
All right. And so now on your MySpace, your record label is Who RC Your Food Productions? What? Does well, this have to do with your dinner set?
No, it's... If you remember the old skit from Saturday Night Live, Crystal Gravy is actually the gravy that lets you see your food.
Oh, okay. So you guys, I'll share with you, like, as Mike was engineering, setting you guys all up, you guys are funny. Like everybody's got a bit of humor.
We appreciate that. We try to be pretty low stress. So.
Yeah. But can somebody share with me, Bill, what is going on your MyPix with that you look naked, hungover, and under a blue blanket?
Bill, I'm gonna let you explain that here.
He's like that all the time.
That was game night is what that was.
And, like football or, you know, thumper.
Yeah. Erotic, yeah, that was Truth or Dare Jenga, I think, is the game we were playing at the time. This is not a band activity that we participate in. Bill and I... yeah, we
that one just got thrown on there for fun, right?
There were women there, too.
Oh, okay. Thank God.
They say that every time, also.
Yeah. Okay, now listen, it looks like tomorrow night you guys have got a performance at Reggie's. Now, there's three rooms in there. Which room are you playing in?
We're in the music joint.
Okay, you're in the music joint.
That's right.
Just where you should be. And now, is there a cover? Or there?
There is a cover. There's a cover for that show. It's $5.
Okay.
You get three bands. We're playing. There's a band called Big Kitchen that's... R&B, funk, kind of similar kind of deal. They have a horn section. And then the last band is a Sublime tribute band.
Okay.
They're called The Catch.
Okay, and so now the music joint is located at 2105 South State Street. Is that correct?
That's correct.
All right, so you're over there by Grant Park.
Uh-huh. And then Wednesday night, we're playing right around this neighborhood.
Uh-huh.
And that's a free show.
Okay,
we're playing at the Red Line Tap.
Yeah, I've been there a time or two. That's a neat... Well, you know, I've been listening to you guys and researching, and I agree with your theory and philosophy of your genre, but... I really get like a funky swing with a combination of a bluesy rhythm, you know, and then your one song, what is it, the gourd?
Spinning Gourds.
I mean, I listened to that, your live performance at Goose Island. What was the crowd was like on acid? I don't know.
Well, they tend to like that tune. You know, Spinning Gourds is the best.
All right. Well, listen, can we get something from the horn section? You know,
just something.
I mean, maybe
on,
like a
careful what you ask for.
a B flat diminished chord.
No, we don't know anything like that.
Yeah, how are you guys doing over there?
Trying to stay quiet.
I can see that. All right, now do you have any upcoming albums or before we get the show started?
We're working on that. We actually record in the studio pretty frequently, but we don't have anything that's a full length album yet. So if you're interested, you can definitely get recordings that we have made. We also have a lot of live recordings.
Okay.
You can contact us through the Sonic Bids page or the MySpace page. And
okay.
But for now, we'd like to play some music.
Oh, okay. Well, why don't you guys take it off and let's get started.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. You are listening to a live performance in Studio 105 here at WNUR 89.3 FM, Evanston, Chicago. And this is Crystal Gravy. We've got the string section, Bill and Drew. And in the percussion section, on drums, we've got Logan and Charly. And in the horn section, we've got Matt on tenor sax, Brent on bari sax, John on trumpet. Now, you guys said that you're playing all originals today. Who composes your compositions? I mean, I'm like...
Well, okay, so for example, the song we just finished, that's called Four Eyes.
Uh-huh.
That's a song that was written entirely by our trumpet player, John Bescup.
Nice.
He basically brings in a chart.
That tune was devoted to my first pair of glasses.
Well, you served them justice, trust me.
And, you know, we always mess with the arrangement a little bit, but the song we opened up with is called Bike Urious.
Uh-huh.
I wrote that song for a band that I played in California, and it's named after a middle manager for a pharmaceutical company named Sean. And Sean would go into work every day, and the front desk woman was, I believe, something like 20 years old.
Uh-huh.
Her name was Kimba. And Sean liked to imagine that Kimba had always been a lesbian from the first moment that she started developing any sexuality. But every time that Sean walked through that front door...
what happened?
She was wondering what it might be like to get some of Sean. So
I'd like to interject that I'm pretty sure that Kimba at no point in her entire sexual career was a lesbian.
Had been, yes. This is
all
the fantasy,
right?
Of Sean, the middle manager at the pharmaceuticals company, yes.
All right, so that song has some history, sexual history at that.
That's right.
All right, so now... you guys will be playing at Reggie's tomorrow night, and you're going to be in the music joint?
Uh-huh. That's correct.
All right. And so now, how often do you get together and practice? I mean, there's seven of you, so...
That's right. There are seven of us, and there are usually three or four at practice. but we do it every week.
Uh-huh.
You know, we're trying to... We come out with new tunes all the time. Oh. We absolutely have never played the same set twice at any show.
All
and
right.
So... Yeah, I think that, you know, we rehearse as much as we can.
Right, right. And, Logan, we're in here on August 9th, which is actually my birthday, and you sat in with a group called Nave.
That's right. They're a soul band I play with occasionally.
But I have to say, you know, I shared with you then, you're a very emotional player, and it looks like most percussion. Charlie's over there. He's pretty emotional about his instruments, too. So, you know, you guys are got the emotion going.
It's a religion for us.
It's a religion? Okay.
That's right. Well, spiritual, yeah. And additionally. Not just emotional, but spiritual.
All right. And so now, just let me ask you, on your MySpace, you got a quote up there at the top of the page, and it says... I mean, who can be a... who? Tell me the quote and who wrote it. Where's that from?
I'm not sure which quote you're referring to. what would that be?
Well, hold on. Oh, it's...
Could that be pour us all over you and your friends?
Yes. I'm like looking at my notes here. You know, I need glasses right about now.
Well, you know, we are the gravy, and we deserve to be poured all over everyone.
All right.
You know, if you don't like our music, then you don't have to check it out any further, but we try to make it so you will.
All right. Well, now listen, I guess, you know, why don't you guys, that was interesting. Well, I actually have one more. I have one more question, though.
What's that?
Whose idea was it to put the art and animation to your MySpace playlist? It's actually pretty groovy.
The photos for each song.
Yeah, I like it.
I suppose I picked those out.
Did you?
Yeah. You know, I try to match them up. The one for the Trizzle is a little bizarre.
Yeah, but, that one was bizarre, but yeah, I think...
But I thought that was pretty funny, so it had to go up.
Yeah.
Check out the one for the Trizzle, all you listeners at home.
That's right. All right, well, listen, this is 89.3 WNUR FM, Evanston, Chicago. We are listening to a live performance by Crystal Gravy in Studio 105. They will be doing another live performance tomorrow night at Reggie's. Tickets are $5. Actually, you know what? What time's your show tomorrow night?
I believe we start at 9.
Okay.
We're playing one set from 9 to 10.
Okay.
And a free show on Wednesday in this neighborhood. All Red right. 9 Tap.
That's right. All right. Well, why don't you guys do what you do best? And
all right. One, two, three, four.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Angelique, and we're listening to Crystal Graving. These, you guys are starting to get a little funky out here in Studio 105. Logan, what's that? It was like, you know, a football game in there for a minute with a
that's
G.
That's right. That's a cheer. That's a cheer.
Yeah. Well, that's what I was thinking. Now, listen, we've got, let's see, in our horn section, we've got Matt, who just did a nice little tenor sax solo for us. And Brent on the bari sax, and John on trumpet, and then in our percussions, there's my brain blurb for the day, percussion section, we've got Logan on drums, and Charly on,
all sorts of stuff.
Yeah, Charlie's like, you know, he's in the corner. And
Charly plays the most instruments out of the entire band, that's for sure.
You know, I thought he had a cross on, but it's actually a whistle. I'm like, where's that noise coming from? It's Charly right. with his whistle.
Well, they did say that percussion was their religion, so. Oh,
yeah. They call it a cruciwhistle.
All right, well, and then we've got, on the strings, we've got, on bass, we've got Bill. And guitar, we've got Drew. And Bill's out there just hamming it up. He's just dancing around in his whole little groove, you know. Drew's just sitting in the chair. It's like, you know, practice session in here. But anyway, I've got a question for the horn section.
Uh-oh.
I was in a marching band. I was a flag girl, and most horn
Does that
guy-
even count?
No, because I was always, my flag was always down when it should be up. And you know, but so anyway, that's part of the show. But were you guys in band? I mean, most horn guys were in band.
Marching band, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, were you?
I did like 75 years of marching band. High school, middle school, college, all that crap.
Yeah, right. Well, you guys sound great. So
actually,
now,
if you look on the Crystal Gravy MySpace page, I'm one of the top friends, and I'm in my marching band uniform.
Oh, you're kidding me.
So proof positive right there.
Well, I knew you were in band. I mean, it's, you know, it's just the way it is. So now you guys are going to be at Reggie's tomorrow night. Tickets are $5. I mean, what's going on? You know, somebody, you guys have song sheets out here. I mean, there must be a lot of preparation and time that goes into your music. And so who does it? How do you do it? I mean, share with people who are not instrumentally inclined.
Well, we all do it. I mean, you know, as far as the composition process, I think we all chip in a little bit. You know, usually a particular member of the band might bring anywhere from a small fragment of a groove to an entire arrangement. Mm-hmm. And then from there, you know, nothing's ever set in stone. We made some changes today before we played some of these songs.
How does that go?
We're actually making all this up on the spot.
Yeah, there's no preparation involved.
Yeah, no,
highly improvisational music.
Yeah, right? Yeah. Well, you guys are geniuses.
What you see, that sheet music, is actually pages from James Joyce.
And then,
using that as
I think some of these pages are upside down too.
All right. Well, I noticed Herbie Hancock is on your like top 16, my friends.
Oh yeah, he is.
Now what's that about? How'd you get Herbie on there?
We're all huge fans of Herbie from the early 70s. About 71, 72, he put a group together called the Headhunters.
Uh-huh.
I'm sure a lot of listeners are familiar with what I'm talking about. Harvey Mason and Paul Jackson were the rhythm section, and Benny Maupin played sax. And
I'm envious of Benny Maupin till the end of the world.
It was a great group. It was a great group. Bill Summers was on percussion, and you know, it was kind of a similar setup to what we have now, except obviously there was a piano involved. But yeah, the albums The Headhunters and Thrust and Manchild are a great period of Herbie's career.
We used to cover a song off Thrust called Spankily.
Spankily? Yeah. That's kind of like Bike Urious?
It's somewhat in the same thing, yeah.
A little nasty.
Yeah. All right, guys. Well, listen, why don't you just take us into... let's see. We've got, you know, some of your titles are... I can't wait till we get
well,
to
the next
section.
I'll tell you what What we just finished playing were Chipwich, Watersports, and Acid Gargle.
Yeah, right?
And we're continuing on with another medley of three here. So.
Okay, let's go.
Google search Watersports. See what happens there.
Oh, not a problem. I'll do that now. I am.
Jet skis and, you know.
Everything I like. We'll be right back. Good afternoon, everyone. This is 89.3 FM WNUR, Evanston, Chicago, and that has got to be the sexiest song. I mean, Drew got out of the chair. I mean, everybody, you know, the whole horn section did a solo. Did you write this? I mean,
no, actually, this is a Nigerian tune. This is written by Fela Kuti.
Okay, this is the one you were talking about.
That's right. He's okay. the father of Afrobeat music.
Genius. Just a genius, and I would say
I
that,
share that opinion. Yes.
Yeah. Right. And I would say you guys did his cover well.
Thank you. I appreciate that. He usually has about 14 to 17 people in the band, not counting the line of women doing backup vocals and percussion instruments. But for seven, we try to do as best as we can.
I think you served this piece justice. definitely. And John, just FYI, I got on here and I see you and your band get up.
Isn't he cute?
He's so, yeah, you know,
Did you see the long hair, too?
Yeah, I was going to say, yeah, how long ago was I like guys in gear, though, I mean, you know.
Oh, that was back in the day, that's from high school.
Oh, okay, yeah, I like it, I like the colors.
But sadly enough, John does still have his marching band uniform, so.
He actually wears it to rehearsal on Wednesday.
Yeah. Oh my God, I'll have to
I actually
that.
Wear it around the house when nobody's around, it's just me, you know, me and my marching band
uniform. Oh, you like to play dress up, huh? Yeah. All right, well, listen, everyone. We've got, we're listening to Crystal Gravy, and they're going to be playing at Reggie's tomorrow night, September 14th, around 9 p.m., and they're going to be in the music joint. Tickets are $5. On percussion section, we've got Logan on drums and Charly, and Charlie's back there in the corner, but he's got more instruments around him than anybody. And the string section, we've got, who do we have? We've got Drew, and we've got Bill. Horn section, we've got Matt, Brent, and John. And what's going on? You guys, I got to hear a little bit more about your songwriting process. I mean, I know it takes a lot of time and a lot of talent. And, what's the process? How do you put your music? I mean, do you do calligraphy and write it out? Or, you know, how do you, like, compose and put it on paper and copy it and give everybody a copy and...
Just about everyone will pitch in with a tune. I mean, somebody will come with sort of a little idea or a small phrase, and we'll kind of work off of that. And that's usually how our song composition process works. Sometimes some of us will bring a whole tune entirely to the group. Like, I've done a couple arrangements, Bill's done a couple arrangements, and Logan's brought a few of his songs too. So once in a while, we'll bring a whole tune.
Mm-hmm.
And I've written charge for the horns. I had to learn some finale in order to do that, so that was a good experience for me. But I think probably one of the best things about this group is the fact that we're constantly bringing new material to the table. And to me, that's one of the most engaging things as a musician, that you may see us a few months from now, and we could be playing an entirely different set list.
Right.
So
right.
I find that a lot really refreshing.
Yeah, and, you know, thank you, John. And, I mean, can anyone else? I guess what I'm trying to get to is, you know, we are WNUR. We are a university radio station. And so I get, you know, we do have a school of music. And I'm enamored with your talent. And so I really just want to know, like, how do you copy this? Do you do it on a computer? I mean, how do you write your song sheet, I guess, is what I'm getting to.
Well, some of it is definitely written out. I went to DePaul, by the way.
Okay, good for you.
Yeah, School of Music in DePaul. So we won't mention that. Don't kick us out now.
All right.
A lot of it... a lot of the music is written out for some of us. Some of us like to read stuff. So, okay. I mean, you know, we'll write out our individual parts. Sometimes we'll just kind of write out a sketch of things.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of time the rhythm section, they just pick stuff up by themselves, or they're creating it on the spot by themselves,
right,
you know?
Right. And along with the string section as well?
Or, yeah. Well, I call them all the rhythm section.
Oh, okay.
It's that half
whole
the
side
band
of the room,
versus
right.
us.
Yeah. That whole side of the room.
Yeah, it's two groups here. I mean, we're not really, we actually met in the parking lot outside today for the first time.
Not all the songs are actually charted out. I mean, we just got our saxophone section here, Brent and Matt, at the top of 2008.
Okay.
Now, we've been around for a few years. We never had charts before that, but we realized we wanted to expand our horn section, and in order to get good players, we had to have charts.
Right.
And so, but as we create new tunes...
Hold on, Logan. So that's what you don't call a song sheet. You actually call it a chart? I mean...
That's what I call it. Sure, you can call it whatever you'd like.
All right.
But
for the listeners,
sheet
FYI
music, yeah. But yeah, as we create more songs, they usually don't necessarily need to be charted out. Okay. You know, I think that's that makes for the most engaging performance at a live show is when, you know, everybody's just interacting with the audience as much as possible.
Right.
Unfortunately, a lot of our music is has a lot of notes in it and can be fairly complex, so a little bit hard to memorize sometimes. But we do the best we can, and yeah, like I said, not every song is charted out. We just we do what we need to do to be able to reproduce the music.
Yeah, and I guess why I'm touching upon this topic is because you are all instrumental, and so I think, you know, notes are key to you know, getting, you know, the Pythagorean theorem going on here.
Wouldn't be a whole lot of sound if we didn't have notes.
Yeah. Actually, if you go to the school of Bill Martinez, the notes are really not that important, actually.
He's the rock star of the group.
Bill is actually the most advanced music theorist of all of us.
Okay, okay.
And he actually transcends every rule that you could think of. The world of music has changed.
That's right. And I guess that's why, you know, we've got that pic of him on your MySpace, you know. He transcends.
Oh, that's right. Oh,
yeah. Anyway, all right. Well, why don't you guys go ahead and wait. Good afternoon, everyone. This is 89.3 FM WNUR, Evanston, Chicago, and that has got to be the sexiest song. Drew got out of the chair. I mean, everybody, you know, the whole horn section did a solo. Did you write this? I mean,
no, actually, this is a Nigerian tune. This is written by Fela Kuti.
Okay, this is the one you were talking about.
That's right. He's the father of Afrobeat music.
Genius. Just a genius, and I would say
I share that opinion. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. And I would say you did his cover well.
Thank you. I appreciate that. He usually has about 14 to 17 people in the band, not counting the line of women doing backup vocals and percussion instruments. But for seven, we try to do as best as we can.
I think you served us peace justice. definitely. And John, just FYI, I got on here and I see you and your band get up.
Isn't he cute?
He's so, yeah, you know,
Did you see the long hair, too?
Yeah, I was going to say, yeah, yeah, how long ago was it? I like guys in gear, though, I mean, you know.
Oh, that was back in the day. That's from high school.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I like it. I like the colors.
But sadly enough, John does still have his marching band uniform. So.
He actually wears it to rehearsal on Wednesday.
Yeah. Oh, my God. I'll have to
wear it around the house when nobody's around. It's just me, you know, and my marching band.
Oh, uniform. You like to play dress up, huh? Yeah. All right. All right, well, listen, everyone. We've got, we're listening to Crystal Gravy, and they're going to be playing at Reggie's tomorrow night, September 14th, around 9 p.m., and they're going to be in the music joint. Tickets are $5. On percussion section, we've got Logan on drums and Charlie, and Charlie's back there in the corner, but he's got more instruments around him than anybody. And the string section, we've got... Who do we have? We've got Drew and we've got Bill. Horn section, we've got Matt, Brent, and John. And what's going on? You guys, I got to hear a little bit more about your songwriting process. I mean, I know it takes a lot of time and a lot of talent. And, you know, what's the process? How do you put your music? I mean, do you do calligraphy and write it out? Or, you know, how do you, like, compose and put it on paper and copy it and give everybody a copy and...
Just about everyone will pitch in with a tune. I mean, somebody will come with sort of a little idea or a small phrase, and we'll kind of work off of that. And that's usually how our song composition process works. Sometimes some of us will bring a whole tune entirely to the group. Like I've done a couple arrangements, Bill's done a couple arrangements, and Logan's brought a few of his songs too. So once in a while we'll bring a whole tune.
Mm-hmm.
And I've written charge for the horns. I had to learn some finale in order to do that, so that was a good experience for me. But I think probably one of the best things about this group is the fact that we're constantly bringing new material to the table. And to me, that's one of the most engaging things as a musician, that you may see us a few months from now and we could be playing an entirely different set list.
Right,
so
right.
I find that a lot really refreshing.
Yeah, yep. And, you know, thank you, John. And, I mean, can anyone else... I guess what I'm trying to get to is, you know, we are WNUR. We are a university radio station. And so I get, you know, we do have a school of music. and I'm enamored with your talent, and so I really just want to know, like, how do you copy this? Do you do it on a computer? I mean, how do you write your song sheet, I guess, is what I'm getting to.
Well, some of it is definitely written out. I went to DePaul, by the way.
Okay, good for you.
Yeah, school of music in DePaul, so we won't mention that. Don't kick us out now.
All right.
A lot of it... a lot of the music is written out for some of us. Some of us like to read stuff. So, okay. I mean, you know, we'll write out our individual parts. Sometimes we'll just kind of write out a sketch of things.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of time the rhythm section, they just pick stuff up by themselves, or they're creating it on the spot by themselves,
right,
you know?
Right, right. And along with the string section as well?
Or, yeah. Well, I call them all the rhythm section.
Oh, okay.
That half the band versus us. Yeah, it's two groups here. I mean, we're not really... We actually met in the parking lot outside today for the first time.
Not all the songs are actually charted out. I mean, we just got our saxophone section here, Brent and Matt, at the top of 2008.
Okay.
You know, we've been around for a few years. We never had charts before that, but we realized we wanted to expand our horn section, and in order to get good players, we had to have charts.
Right.
And so, but as we create new tunes...
Hold on, Logan. So that's what you don't call a song sheet. You actually call it a chart. I mean...
That's what I call it. Sure, you can call it whatever you'd like.
All right.
But
for the listeners, you know,
sheet
FYI.
Music, yeah. But yeah, as we create more songs, they usually don't necessarily need to be charted out. You know, I think that's that makes for the most engaging performance at a live show, is when everybody's just interacting with the audience as much as possible.
Right.
Unfortunately, a lot of our music has a lot of notes in it, and can be fairly complex, so a little bit hard to memorize sometimes, but we do the best we can, like I said, not every song is charted out. We just we do what we need to do to be able to reproduce the music.
Yeah, and I guess why I'm touching upon this topic is because you are all instrumental, and so I think, you know, notes are key to getting the Pythagorean theorem going on here.
Wouldn't be a whole lot of sound if we didn't have notes.
Yeah. Actually, if you go to the school of Bill Martinez, the notes are really not that important, actually.
He's the rock star of the group.
Bill is actually the most advanced music theorist of all of us.
Okay.
And he actually transcends... every rule that you could think of. The world of music has changed.
That's right. and I guess that's why, you know, we've got that pic of him on your MySpace, you know. He transcends.
Oh, yeah. Right. Oh, yeah.
Anyway, all right. Well, why don't you guys go ahead and... wait a second. Now, we're getting ready to do...
this is our dinner set.
This is my favorite set. Wait, I got to say the songs. Potato Breath, That Must Be to the Irish. Dinty Moore. What's that about?
It depends. There's an argument going on within the band about what this is really about.
The full title is Dinty Moore's Technicolor Powwow.
So. Oh, my God. Don't do that on a drunk twister.
it could either be a comic or a stew or a writer. I wrote it in honor of the writer, so I'll plug out to Dinty Moore, the author. Go look him up.
Okay, Judd, I got you. And then we've got turkey and pan-fried lamb.
Yeah, actually wild turkey and pan-fried lamb.
Oh,
yeah.
Wild turkey.
But you got it. That's the right song. Yeah.
All right.
Wild turkey.
I'm right there with you, buddy.
That's right.
All right, well, listen, we're listening to Crystal Gravy. This is WNUR 89.3 FM, Evanston, Chicago, Airplay Sound Experience. Crystal Gravy.
This will be our dinner set. Thank you.
Thank you.
amazing. Oh my God. This is WNUR 89.3 FM. Sound experience, airplay, and we've got a live performance by Crystal Gravy going on in Studio 105. And for those of you who need a visual, these guys
all need a visual.
Everybody. Now listen, guys. Now, we haven't talked...
Our saxophones are Siamese twins.
What was going on over here in the horn side? I mean, you guys are like... bobbing up and down and, like, you know, having a little competition. What's going on?
We try to mess each other up as much as we can, you know, and if I dance, he can't keep a straight face. So.
Yeah, right. It was good.
And if I take my pants off, he can't keep a straight face.
So. No, that's a visual.
You might see that tomorrow night at Reggie's.
Hey. All right. Well, listen, everybody, we've got... Crystal Gravy in the house, and they will be playing at Reggie's tomorrow night, September 14th, and tickets are $5, and while we're talking about music and you and how to see you, we've had some callers that want to know how to purchase you, and where do they go to do that?
Well, the best way for them to do that is to come to our shows, and I will definitely have discs available for probably about $1 a piece.
Okay.
The other way is you can send us a message on our MySpace page, which is myspace.com/crystalgravyfunk. If you give us some personal information, I'd be happy to send you some stuff in the mail.
Okay.
You could just email me directly. My email is lowbeats@yahoo.com, and if you give me any kind of information that I need to get you whatever you want, I will give it to you.
Okay, so for all you listeners out there, you know, we got lowbeats.com. And, you know, actually, since we're kind of getting ready to wrap it up, can I maybe get Bill and Drew and Charlie to maybe step by one of the mics and let's give them a little airtime and say hi, other than the instruments. Where'd you come from? Who are you? What's going on in the world, Drew?
Hey, everybody. I'm Drew, yeah. And I don't know. I'm from New Jersey, and I play guitar with these guys. I know Bill, so...
All right.
The gig here.
Yeah. Actually, how did you guys... How did you guys all meet, since I got all the boys together right now? How'd you all meet?
Well, I knew this guy.
At a whorehouse.
All right. Paris, France, you know.
I was trafficking some... Well...
All right,
some
Bill.
Some bull dung.
Yeah.
So anyway, yeah, I knew Bill from another band that we had played in, and I guess Bill and Logan have been playing together for a long time.
Yeah. Well, you know, Logan came in and played with Nave. That's how I met him, but I will share with you, Logan, you are right. This is definitely your day gig. He really, you know, talked... Highly recommended all of you guys just as musicians in general. And Charlie.
Yes.
He likes his corner, man.
I like my corner.
All the drums.
What's going on, Charlie? Where are you from? What's your background? You've got a lot of instruments.
How much time do you have?
Well, 5 minutes.
I was born in Miami. I come from sunny areas, basically. I grew up in the Dominican Republic.
Uh-huh.
And I just like to smack skins. That's what I'm all about.
Well, I've been watching
smacking skins and rattling gourds. So this was a perfect group, you know?
Yeah, right. Well,
and when you throw food into the mix, then it's a whole other experience. Well, so that's why...
Yeah. I've been watching you smack some good skin over there, you know.
Yeah, some good skin smacking.
I'm jealous.
Back to that visual again.
Yeah, right. We all like the visuals.
I actually recruited Charlie. You can see his, he leads a lot of percussion groups around Chicago. Mofo Orisha is the name of the one. I went and saw them play, and I was really impressed with what Charlie had put together there.
Okay.
So I talked to him after the show. And
So Charlie, you're more of a session musician. I mean, you play. Do all of you guys play with other bands, or is this your day gig?
This is my day gig.
Okay. Drew. Bill is like, he doesn't know.
Yeah, lately it's been consuming a lot of my time, yes.
Yeah, okay. All right, well, listen, you guys, we got to do the station ID and turn this over to the next show. But I want to thank Bill on bass, Logan on drums, Drew on guitar, Charlie on percussion, Matt on tenor sax, Brent on bari sax, John on trumpet, Crystal Gravy, thank you for coming in. And everybody, check him out at Reggie's tomorrow night or the Red Line Tap on the 17th of September, Lily's on the 25th, Glance on the 31st of October. And thank you guys. We appreciate you coming out in the rain today.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
The sound.
Yeah.
got drunk and stuff.
I don't know, man. I was gonna see if any of these guys wanted to do it for dinner. What do you guys think about that? Anybody want to go out to dinner?
Where?
Wherever.
Well, I've got to go to Hippolito's birthday party.
Yeah, but that's not until later.
So now,
it starts at 7.
Okay, so what time? Because I got to go play at this place. I don't know. I don't even know what bar it's at.
It's at a bar.
Yeah, man. See?
Hugs around the room. Everybody. You know what I'm
saying? You have to pay.
Thank you. You guys are like, oh my gosh, you guys are great.
House parties,
everybody. Charlie, you're back there, buddy, but
you guys
don't play hugs. Thank you. Oh my god. You guys are all sweaty.
Yes.
That's
what
happens.
Hugs, Logan.
Thank you for
being
a
lazy piece of shit.
I was being lazy. I was just staying comfortable, man. It's comfortable over here.
Those guitar players are amazing.
Your hair is long, man.
Thank you
guys.
Thanks for having us.
No, you guys are great. I am like, people were calling. I mean, how do they see you? Where do they get your music? You guys really should. I mean, why don't you do like an album or something?
I think that's in the plans for.
I think we want to. Yeah.
That's in the plans for like the next over the next 6 months or so.
Is it? I mean, because you guys are so good. I mean, like literally.
It was a 4-piece group.
Right.
It was Logan and Bill and John and another guitar player, and then they picked Drew up. And then when they wanted to expand,
we were a power trio originally with.
Yeah,
they were
really
just
a trio.
And drums.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And but now, so now with the one second. You guys got a hold
two of
it,
us up and Charlie, so it's we're still trying to figure out how to play together.
Right. Yeah, but still, what you're doing right now is like.
I'd say we're well on the way.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, I'm not
complaining. Definitely. Yeah, and I'm definitely going to try and make it a Reggie tomorrow night.
Oh, sweet. Cool.
Yeah, definitely. So now you guys do start at 9?
Yeah.
Or like 9, between 9 and 9:30 probably.
Yeah,
right? Yeah.
Hop right out of nowhere. Hop right out of nowhere. Hop right out of nowhere. Hop right out of nowhere.